failure is not an option.
What difference at this point does it make?
Nobody said it was going to be fun.
This is Real Talk, a fearless, poignant, and intrepid show where truth speaks louder than words. This is Real Talk with your host, Audrey Russo.
The shade, not of this world, so we live on the run. We keep our eyes set, on what is to come.
It happened before. It will happen again. It's just a question of when.
Time's a luxury we don't have.
Hey, get her done. Hey, this is Larry the Cable Guy, and I'll tell you what. When I get my news, I get it from Real Talk from Audrey Russo. Yeah, buddy. Get her done.
Welcome back. If you're just joining us, this is Audrey Russo, and you're listening to Real Talk. The midterms are coming, and the Democrats are like desperate, wheezing animals. Are there any limits to their dirty deeds to maintain power? Well, we're going to hit this and more with my next guest. For my new listeners, Matt Nagin is a comedian and author. He has published 4 books, including his most recent, Do Not Feed the Clown, by 10th Street Press. He's appeared on several reality shows, performed in numerous TV and film projects, and performs stand-up in 7 countries. And he's here to drop some knowledge on us. It's my great pleasure to give a Real Talk welcome back to Matt Nagin.
Thanks, brother. Nice.
I love the simulated applause. It's great, great to be here with you in these crazy times.
No, it's awesome. Yeah, they're actually real and they're maskless, okay? Because we don't worry about airborne stuff. So, I mean, there's such a menu here to discuss, but let me see. What's the least? No, this is probably the most disgusting. No, not really. World Economic Forum, okay, since none of us can travel anywhere, okay, because gas prices, they are... These freaks are telling us to drop fossil fuels. In other words, die, okay? So, because 85 to 90% of what we do in this country, besides traveling, and that includes traveling, is done on fossil fuels. Klaus Anal Schwab said that gas prices must go even higher to save democracy. So my guess is he's redefined save to mean destroy. Am I right?
I think so, because these gas prices are just so crazy. I mean, if you think about it, I'm down here in Alabama, and it was about $2 a gallon about 2 years ago. And, you know, the prices can really get up there. Now, in certain parts of the country, I see it up at $7.
Yeah.
I mean, the other day I was driving, and I was thinking of filling up my tank, and I wanted to... consult with my broker at Charles Schwab. You know, this is a serious investment, right? you know, you have to get like quarterly reports. I'm like, do I do the Exxon or Sunoco? Because
the
amount I have to spend for this tank of gas, it's absurd what they've done. And now they want it higher, and they want us to eat bugs or something.
Oh man, they are so disgusting.
I don't like cockroaches, you know, especially the ones that are running our country. But you know, I don't want to eat them. I don't know about you. I don't want to eat bugs. That's just weird. Then we'll get another pandemic, the cockroach pox or something. So, you know, I don't know what you think about that. But.
Yeah, they would love it, you know, because remember, this doesn't touch them. None of this touches them. It just touches us. And, of course, it makes everything more expensive. I mean, everything. I talked to a friend who's in beverage. They're a beverage distributor, and they were saying, you know, they didn't even realize themselves that the plastic bottles are made from fossil fuels. So, so they're having trouble getting stuff. And this is the way. They would love us to. You notice if you notice that the regime, I won't call them an administration, but the regime is saying, well, you know, we're in a transition. Yeah, the transition is they want to get us on alternative energy that doesn't work, okay? So that means death for Americans. It does. It means more people will die. Because try to get to a winter without having gas, okay? And instead, what? Something that if a bird comes over and poops on it, it's going to be gone, okay? I'm sorry to be crude, but, you know, I mean, I've even seen some of those windmills, which, by the way, froze in Texas. We didn't forget that. And they didn't even, you know, Texans didn't even know that 25% of their energy was coming from windmills, all right? And then until, of course, they had that deep freeze, and then they found out, okay? And it's one thing to the air conditioner to go out. It's another to have your heat go out. And, you know, hypothermia is what you die from, not from sweating, you know? So, I mean, this is where they want us.
And you should send the bill to Biden because he's they're outsourcing all our resources. You know, they gave all our weapons to the Taliban.
Yeah.
They gave all our oil to China. And what else did Biden do? He gave his coke to his son, Hunter. So, you know, it's ridiculous with this guy. I mean, he's not holding on to anything, you know. So,
no.
I don't know. It's ridiculous. The country's gone crazy to me.
It is. But we can't. We're not going to be able to survive going in this direction. They know that, you know, but they really don't care, basically, okay? The ones that are in charge don't care. And the people that we put in office to stand against these people are just sitting there twiddling their thumbs and going, oh, we'll get in in November. And I'm thinking, that's not how you do it, okay? When you represent someone, you speak up for us. You speak against what you see is wrong, okay? Like our border or our non-border, okay? There's no border, okay? And Biden told because this is very personal to me, because my late dad started out his career in federal law enforcement as a border agent. And he's telling the border agents to not to stop them from coming in. And they named every area where they come in, how they come in. Just don't stop them. And I'm thinking, so basically you're violating, the government is violating our laws.
Mm.
So they're just running over the border, thousands upon thousands, all the time. You know,
got to do something down there. And I heard they're building up the wall.
Yeah, it was like
building up the wall.
It's a one foot by one foot.
Yeah.
Everybody's going around it. Okay, so yeah, I don't, you know, and it's the fentanyl that's coming over that's killing us. There, I mean, you name it. It's right. Child sex trafficking is out the wall. You know, when we were all locked down, I talked with my friend Craig Sawyer from Veterans for Child Rescue, and he said the only thing that was booming during that time was child sex trafficking over the border while we were all locked down.
Wow. Yeah, it seems like, to me, I don't know if I'm right here, but they're trying to kill us a little bit.
It's
not the vaccine, which I think is questionable. Then it's this fentanyl. And if it's not that, there was a report that there's glyphosate, which is a Roundup, in 80% of our urine. 80% of people that they tested. This is the CDC.
Oh my gosh!
So they're poisoning us. I mean, any way you look, you're getting hit. So I don't know, man. The country's gone off the deep end.
Yeah.
And then the way they're did you see what they're doing with the kids? They're pitching the vaccine to the kids through a commercial with Elmo.
What?
I don't know if you saw that one.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Elmo's like, I got vaccinated, kids. You got it too. And I was like, I couldn't believe it.
That's
that
sick.
That they stooped that low to go with Elmo. You know, like, what's next? Is Big Bird going to work for Raytheon? You know what I mean? You know, is the Cookie Monster going to be in the Pentagon starting World War III? This is just absurd that they, you know, it's kind of.
I think Big Bird is there. His name is Millie, but go ahead. He's a freaking clown, okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, but no, it's true. Yeah, it's to go after the kids, these people are sick, okay? I'm giving them an excuse. They're evil going after the kids. They are not susceptible to any of those, that virus. No, not at all. And yet you want to give them a shot that they now admit doesn't stop you from getting it, doesn't stop you from being sick, and doesn't stop you from dying from it. So what are you giving it to the kids for? Right.
And the clinical trials show no efficacy. But they still said it's better, the benefits outweigh the drawbacks based on nothing.
That's a lie.
If we're following the science says not to do it. You need efficacy.
Yes, exactly. No, but instead, now what do we have? Why don't you tell everybody what SADS is?
Oh, right. SADS. Yeah. So that's SADS, SADS. This thing is crazy. It's there's been an increase in deaths, unexplained deaths, over the past year that people have attributed to different things. Some people say it could be an injection given to 4 billion people. But whatever it is, they need a way to explain all this increase, and they came up with a condition called SAD, Sudden Adult Death Syndrome.
Gosh.
And, you know, as soon as I heard that, Audrey, my antenna went off because I'm like, what is this thing, sudden adult death syndrome? Like, they make it like this thing's been here forever. And, of course, that can't be true because if there was, you know, think about cancer. There's cancer centers everywhere. There's Sloan Kettering, you know, there's the Gerson Institute. You know, there's places where you can go. There's no sudden adult death center, right? We keep you from dying immediately. Like, that's just not a real thing.
It's not.
And you don't have people saying they went to their doctor and giving them 3 minutes to live. Sorry, you got sad. Nothing we can do. You know, it's like something they pulled out of thin air.
Yeah.
And
that's what they did.
People are reading this and being like, wow, I hope I don't have sad. You know, like, because this is absurd to me.
It is. Well, to think that we're going to believe that, because it seems almost every day they're coming out with a new absurd thing to say. Like, one thing we've known for years is taking a nap is good because if you can, because it refreshes the body, right? Mm-hmm. Now they say, oh, you don't know, it could bring on sudden death if you take it. Then they say, this is for young people, okay, that if you don't take a cold shower because a cold shower can cause you to have a heart attack. And I'm thinking, what are you kidding? And then, oh my gosh, this is so sick. All right. So once they okayed the jab for children, then suddenly they now okayed what? Blood thinner for children, because, you know, after all, children can get blood clots. Since when? Since when? Have you ever heard this rash of children getting blood clots? No. Oh my gosh.
No, absolutely not.
This is sick.
You know, like, I actually, if these people were in this administration was around during the Holocaust, they'd probably say 6 million Jews had SADS. Like,
SADS,
this is
oh my gosh.
I'm sorry, that's off color. But
I know, but I understand what you're saying. Yeah, I wouldn't put past them to say something like that. Yeah, exactly. Because what are they going to say? The Veyers, of course, is not even honest anymore. But they used to, just with 1%, the number of deaths was stunning. Then we find out that in the first, what was it, the first month, that they with the jab, the first month of the jab, 1,200 people died from it. 57 people died of the last time they had done one like this, and they pulled it. Why? That was back then. Right. There are so many in this country that have just suddenly died. Mm-hmm. And young people, the young people that are just dying, athletes, okay? Mm-hmm. Young swimmer, there was a doctor, and she drops dead. I'm thinking to myself, you're kidding me, right? In college athletes dying. Why? Because they forced them to get this jab.
Right.
And you just...
That's a crime against humanity.
Of course it is.
Schwab should be on trial at The Hague. You know, Fauci should be in the stocks. gates to be pilloried and tarred and feathered. You know,
this oh, I'm for tarred and feathered. Yeah, absolutely. Because to me, that's more torture. I looked that up and found out what tar and feathering was. From I'm down with it. Okay, because these people have to know, have to understand in a real way what they have done.
Right.
And it's still happening. It's still happening to people, you know? I mean,
bring back corporal punishment for these people.
Oh, I'm absolutely, I want them to be prosecuted. I don't want to pay for their jail time. I want us to build the gallows again.
Right.
I'm serious.
No, absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, Gates too, you got so much dirt on him. I mean, he has like 16 trips to the Epstein Island. I mean, his wife broke up with him because of illicit dealings. So, you know, there's something going on there. If he's not a pedophile, he's
there's something not right. Yeah,
associated with one.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
You know, so,
well, if it wasn't wrong, why was he hiding it?
Sure, sure. And now they got started up on this monkeypox.
I saw. I was just going to tell you that. Yeah.
Yeah. They declared that a national emergency. The monkey. See, and the CDC has all these warnings, but at no point, you know, it seems to affect the gay population. At no point do they say, maybe knock off the gay orgies. You know, maybe that's a good idea.
No, exactly. So it's like unlike HIV, it passed on through sexual contact, especially in the gay and bi community. Well, then don't tell people this is a national emergency. Don't tell them to mask up. All right, because that's not where it is, okay?
Right.
And it doesn't get transmitted that way. And so the majority of people really are not afraid. It's just people in blue states, unfortunately, like New York, that are listening to them. But monkeypox has been known that it's transmitted that way through you know, sexual contact. And it's unbelievable that they would try to. I thought, no, if you're going to try anything, it's not going to work this time because, you know, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me.
Right. But the people are lining up for the monkeypox vaccine.
I know. Where did this come from, right?
They're all like lines of people in L.A. and all over. Like they're like, I got to get it. I got to get that monkeypox. They're like, there's a shortage of monkeypox. People can't wait to get more. I couldn't believe all that. And there's an outbreak supposedly in New York. But in Costa Rica, you know, they got all these monkeys. They got no monkeypox. How do you explain that?
Yeah, exactly. How do you explain that? But, of course, where is it? Down in Greenwich Village. It's down in Chelsea. It's down in the gay community. But you're not allowed to say that, right?
Right. You go to the Bronx Zoo. The monkeys are fine.
How do they explain that?
I can't tell what is real and what is not anymore. I'm going to be honest with you.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm almost living in a simulacrum because if you had told me that there was monkeypox and people are freaking out, I would think this is like a B movie from the 1950s, you know, like the Attack of the Killer Tomatoes or something.
Like, oh. Don't be so sure that's not next. Okay?
Yeah, right.
Then you really have to wonder how this. We're living in a very bad B movie. Yeah, they're lining up for monkeypox shots. I'm going, but you don't realize is those BioNTech. The things that are under EUA, they're experimental, and they just slapped on a monkeypox vax on there. Where do they think this was developed? All of a sudden, monkeypox vax. Nobody's asking this question.
Exactly. And I'm sure they're getting the vials mixed up. They got so many of these damn vaccines now. I don't know which is which. You know, you end up getting the wrong thing. You get tetanus or something, and then you think. I don't trust these people. I don't want to get any of their shots, any of their injections.
No.
I'm done. I'm out.
Yeah.
I'm gone. Yeah. Like any of their things. I'm in Costa Rica with the monkeys. Fine.
It's safer with the monkeys right now.
Yeah. I'm living with a monkey right now. He's fine. I'm fine. It's good. You know, we're all good. Everything's fine.
Yeah, but it's true. You know, it's a sad day when we can't trust the people that we hire. Remember, we pay them and they're lying to us and they're benefiting themselves. And sadly, it's on both sides of the aisle. But this is what they're doing. And for what? For money? For money. So you're killing off people in the population because, after all, it doesn't matter to you. And you continue to lie. And we're paying you to do this.
Right. And we're paying. You're supposed to be the health expert, Dr. Fauci.
Yeah.
You entitled garden gnome.
Yes, he is a garden gnome.
You know, so this guy is supposed to be the expert. And then he gets the COVID, he takes the Paxlovid, and it comes back. And then Biden follows, he gets the COVID, and it comes back. I mean, these people don't know what they're doing. Their lives are evidence not to listen to them.
Exactly.
But people still want to line up for the fifth shot because they're coming out with Omicron bivalent vaccine. Everyone's like, oh, well, this one's so much better. No, there are... BA1, the first Omicron. There already are five other Omicrons. And by the time it comes out, there'll be five more. You know what I mean?
That's the nature of a virus. That's the way it's always been. You know, it's like, what do? We just come off the turnip truck or something? Because we've always dealt with the viruses, stomach viruses, all kinds of viruses.
Yeah, if only there was something that could defend us against Omicron. Oh, that's right, there is an immune system.
Exactly. How is it? How do they explain this? How is it that these people who keep getting jabbed and, you know, like in other words, the definition of insane, but I say it's insane and stupid, that if one medication doesn't work, you don't keep using the same thing, right? Well, they keep getting the same shot over and they don't realize it. This is the same shot over and over again. Your immune system's getting suppressed, so you're getting sick over and over again. Mm-hmm. What exactly are you, how is it that I, who am not vaccinated, I got it back in 2020 and now I'm immune? How come we're not dropping dead in the streets? How come we're not in the hospital? Well, gee, as you just said, the immune system that God gave us, it's really an amazing mechanism, the way it works.
If only Pfizer could find a way to profit off the immune system, then we'd be fine. If only they get their greedy hands in there. But I saw their quarterly report. They were very excited because they said this could really work out well because the vaccines aren't working as well as they hoped. Hoped in parentheses. But it's okay because we're selling two doses of Paxlovid to all these people because the first doesn't work. So they're raking in record profits. They got like 90 billion.
Yeah.
So I think that's their whole plan, is to make drugs now that don't work and give them to everybody, and then they have to keep profiting. You know, it's
and that's what they're doing. And that's why they were doing the children when they realized 28 million children. How much is that per shot? Yeah, let's just give it to them. You know, we'll charge the same thing, and if something happens, we'll just say, "Oh, you know, it's a what is it, little kid?" They're gonna do it, sad SIDS, and what's in between? They're gonna do something in between. I mean, I know we have to laugh about it because otherwise, it's too tragic. You know, I mean, that's another thing. which I, before we finish here, we have to talk about this because we have lost our sense of humor in this country. We don't know how to laugh at ourselves, and that's really sick. Now, I just put out, I don't know if you saw it, but I just put out a clip from Monty Python from 42 years ago. Somebody put this out where they talk about how insane the situation is, and what's said there, everyone, you got to check it out. It's out on Twitter. It is unbelievable, and it's brilliant, and it's prescient, and I couldn't believe that they were saying what they were saying in this clip, but it was really brilliant because we need to be able to laugh at ourselves. We can't, if you tell the truth, you get, canceled, okay? They'll do everything to shut you up, but we can't laugh at ourselves anymore. I mean, actors... So if I'm not Asian, okay, and I want to play it Asian, it's an insult to Asian. Why is it an insult to Asians if I can play the role? Now you can't play it unless with it. That's not acting then.
Exactly. The world has gone completely nuts. I mean, Dustin Hoffman would be considered, a anti-autist or something he played Rain Man, you know, because and that was one of the most brilliant performances.
Absolutely.
Actually, I'm an actor as well, and I love roles when it's outside my comfort zone. And in terms of laughing, you got to. I thought that was rule one, just to be able to laugh at yourself, to have a sense of humor. Well, but nowadays, the Ministry of Disinformation Board or whatever, Nina Jankowicz, I guess laughter is a federal crime. I mean,
well, in communist countries, you don't have any comedians, do you? No, because you can't laugh at the regime. You can't laugh at anything. So, that's the way it is. So, that's not who we are as Americans. For goodness sakes, Don Rickles would never make it. They would have shut him down. You know, I love looking at the Dean Martin roasts. It was hysterical. You laugh at every, because if you don't, you're not going to be healthy in this life.
Absolutely. And I want to go to Tehran for the more open-minded audience. You know?
Yeah, right.
That's where democracy is born now, comparatively. So, you know, no, but I love Rickles. I mean, he's like a master. I love watching those Dean Martin roasts too. I mean, just to see him work a room like the plate spinner. And, you need people like that. And that's part of why our culture is so sick. We can't laugh at ourselves anymore. We take ourselves so seriously. Yeah. I mean, some can, like you and me.
Yeah.
But we're rare. Yes. I'm not saying we're rare, but, you know, most people now, they need their safe space and their little milk bottle.
Yeah.
And then suck their thumb and go in a corner and, you know, ask for mommy or something.
Yeah. So. Yeah, but it's true, and it's really unhealthy for this nation. We have to learn, and that's why we depend on comedians, and comedians have to stand up for themselves and say, no, I'm not going to, no way am I going to bow to this. Because you see Dave Chappelle and my friends Ellen Karras and Greg Morton and all of them, and you stand up against it, because if you don't, look, we depend on comedians to help us laugh at ourselves and our situations in life. You have to, again, because you can't take that inside your body. It's going to make you sick if you can't laugh it off. You got to be able to laugh it off. And
absolutely.
Yeah.
And you can add that to the all the other things that are killing us is the no sense of humor. You know, that everyone's a tightwad. They should start the tightwad party and put all these clowns in it so people know.
Yeah, exactly right.
Yeah, that's what you should have in Congress, a clown come in and with the three-piece band and lighten the mood in there. Cause,
you know. Yeah, right. Believe me, they're laughing behind our backs in Congress, but we will end up having the last laugh, believe me. Matt, where can the listeners follow and support your excellent work? Because they should be able to hear you and read your stuff.
Absolutely, yes. No, I have... Some stories coming out in new journals, but I have the humor book, Do Not Feed the Clown. It's on Amazon, Barnes & Nobles. And I have some shows coming up. You can check my calendar, mattnagin.com. I'm doing a temple down here in Birmingham, actually.
All right.
Up. And I'll be in September, I'll be in New York doing some shows. And just check me out on Twitter, Instagram, all that stuff. So M. Nagin on Twitter and Nagin Please on Instagram. Thank you so much, Audrey.
Oh, sure. Well, it's my pleasure. And as always, I will have those links in my after show, so you don't have to search for them. They'll be right there on the live show page. Just go to AudreyRusso.com, click on the on-air button, and right under the show description, you'll find all the links and info that Matt just shared. Thanks so much, Matt, for sharing everything with us. I love your perspective, which is awesome. Will you join us again on the show? Yes?
Absolutely.
Awesome. Until then, may God bless you, your work, and may God save America. Bye for now.